General Wilson Badi welcomed his South Sudan counterparts to the 4th Infantry Barracks in Gulu City. The meeting is meant to broker peace along the international border between the two East African countries. The Ugandan Chief of Defense Forces says the meeting is also meant to weed out the two wrong rebel groups of the National Salvation Army, commonly known as NAS, and the Ugandan National Liberation Force, which are recruiting people in the refugee settlements along the Ugandan border stretch from Koboko to Kenya.
Uganda will do everything in its ability to ensure strategic security for our two countries and region through regional cooperation as a vehicle for prevention of our identity, for preserving our identity and African heritage, our independence and sovereignty. We look forward to a continued interaction as a way of building confidence and mutual trust among the two forces, with the aim of building capacity to defeat not only the negative armed groups in the region, but also expose the works of the invisible hand that is behind proxy destabilization of our region.
It is believed that since 2016, the wrong elements have been causing insecurity along the Uganda-South Sudan border, with recruits being promised a monthly stipend of $500 to $700. The South Sudan delegation arrived in the country on Saturday, 6th of August, and met the Ugandan CDF at the Lumumba Recreation Triangle.
Also being strict on the refugee influx, because some of these guys who pretend to be refugees actually are combatants running away either from operations against by the government or deserting.
The South Sudan delegation was led by General James Kawong Chawul, the assistant CDF of the South Sudan People's Defense Forces in charge of training. General Kawong put emphasis on the need for the two countries to unite and forget the colonial boundaries. The meeting also served as a review of the recommendations of the Gulu 2020 Joint CDF meeting.
The family which is not talking is not a family. Nobody today can accept that to have a problem with the new Guinea or with the Uganda. Because during those days when we were in the fighting with the Khartoum government, it's the only new Guinea that is telling us possible. Even now, in the area of our area of Yemen and the border with the Congo, there are a lot of activities that, if we don't handle ourselves well, situation means we can accuse ourselves and ourselves. But I'm really happy to discuss these issues with you, the counterpart, my brother in Uganda. These things are not serious to me.
South Sudan, Africa's youngest nation, is currently being ruled by President Salva Kiir's loyal South Sudan People Defense Forces and the rebel South Sudan People's Liberation Army in opposition that are loyal to the first Vice President, Riek Machar.
These people create situations that are not there so that we don't unite to deal with the bigger problems that affect us, to keep us engaged on the smaller issues of border tensions between the communities, when actually they are strategic plans.
Report by Joseph Omagol for the news in Gulu City.